At the 1952 Games in Helsinki, Emil Zátopek, already a phenomenon as Olympic champion, was preparing to do what no other athlete had done before, the impossible treble, the 5,000 meters, 10,000 meters, and the marathon.
There was a chance to run all these long distances, but there was one big unknown for me. What are my chances for distances longer than 10,000 meters?
He retained his 10,000-meter title with an amazing 100-yard victory. But Zátopek knew that the 5,000 meters was always going to be the real challenge. Zátopek planned to sprint into the lead in the hope that his main rivals would become discouraged. But instead, they overtook him.
But I kept running, and a strange thing happened. 200 meters from the finish, the other runners were at the end of their string.
Zátopek somehow managed to pass them again, and in his unmistakable style, went on to victory. Zátopek's ambitions were now firmly focused on the marathon, and only 3 days later, he was at the starting line with 65 other runners. His inexperience at the distance made him seek out the world record holder, Jim Peters.
Before the start, I found number 187 and went up to him and said, "How do you do, please? Are you Peters?" "Yes, I'm Peters. I'm Zátopek, Czechoslovakia. I'm very glad to see you."
Peters took off at a thunderous pace.
I asked if it wasn't too fast, but he said, "No, it must be run this way."
Peters began to fall behind, leaving Zátopek with Sweden's Gustav Jansson in the lead at the halfway point. And then Jansson's challenge diminished, and Zátopek was left on his own at the front.
I came into the stadium for the third time as a winner, and it seemed to be that the ovations were endless. All the people were applauding. And for me, it was the most beautiful end to an Olympic race.
Zátopek had achieved what was said to be impossible, a feat unlikely ever to be repeated.